Hey everybody. So yeah, as I promised, I am going to walk us through a quick tutorial on how to complete the density FET lab, since there was a little bit of communication for our group. So let me share screen with you guys really quickly. Alrighty. So first off, you can access the handout and the link for the FET simulation. On Canvas. So just scroll down to Chapter 1, Chemistry in Our Lives, Part 2. Here you will find the Density FET student handout. So you can open that up. Notice it's a PDF, or it's actually a Word document. So you can open this up in Word and enter in your values directly if you like, or you can print it out and write by hand if you prefer. So it should look like this. There's basically three segments. There's this first page that has three parts and another question. There's a part D with a custom section, and then a part E with a mystery section. And then don't forget, there are some questions right here on the side of part D. All right, so to answer these questions, you will need to access the FET simulator, which is right here. You can access the address here, or you can come over back to Canvas and find the link to the simulator here in Canvas, okay? And then the link to upload your finished report is right under it in this assignment. So you're just gonna click the link for the FET simulator, and it's gonna open it up. And you'll see we have three different tabs. We have an intro tab, a compare tab, and a mystery tab. In order to complete the first part of the FET or the worksheet, you're gonna click on compare and open that up. You should get four different colored boxes, and they're labeled A, B, C, and D. And then all you have to do is, let me kind of do these side by side. So I have both windows open at the same time. Oops. Here we go. Okay. So I've got my simulator and I've got my handout, and I'll zoom in so it's a little easier to see. All right, so for the first experiment, you are going to be looking at the different boxes with all the same mass. So make sure that we have selected same mass under this blocks menu. And you can note that the mass is already recorded for you. You can also change the mass if you like. You can make it lighter or bigger, however way you like. Okay. So I'll just see if I can reset this. Well, it's going to stay at 4.8. I like to do just a nice round number. Sometimes let me toggle in and out to reset it. Okay, it's not going to reset. That's fine. So we'll just leave it at 4.9. If you open it and start it, it'll start out at 5. All right. So now what you're going to do is you can go ahead and record the mass for all your boxes. So blue, yellow, green, red, they're all the same because we've set them to all the same. The next thing you want to do is you want to test and figure out what is the volume of each of these boxes. And to do that, we're going to use volume displacement. So you're going to select your box. So we'll start with the blue box, which is A, and you are going to drop it into this pool of water. Now, the first thing I want you to note is you can see what the initial volume is. It's 100.00 liters. So that's the initial volume of this pool of water. When we add the block, that pool of water is going to increase proportionally to the volume of the box, right? And this is because the mass of the box is taking up volume, and so the water has to move in order to make room for the box. So as long as your box is completely submerged, sometimes you may have to click and drag it underwater in order to completely submerge it, because some of these boxes will float, as you can see here. So to get it to completely submerge, we may have to click and drag it down, and then note what is the volume after we've submerged the box, right? So click and drag it down, and you'll write down that the final volume is 105.00. Again, notice if your box isn't completely submerged, if it's floating, you'll see that you're not going to get an accurate reading of your volume. It's going to be less, right? Because some of the box is not under the water. Therefore, it's not going to displace the water. So make sure you click and drag it down. So for the second column in this table right here, you're going to write down the volume displaced, or the difference between the final volume, such as here, which is 105.00, minus the initial volume, which is 100.00. That answer would be 5.00. And so I would write that here in the volume column. Then you're going to calculate your density. So remember, density is going to be equal to your mass, which in this case would be 4.9, divided by your volume, which was 5.00. And therefore, your density is going to be a little less than 1 kilograms per liter. So do that calculation and enter that into your third column. And then finally, the fourth column is going to ask you, does this float or not? And so again, you can test to see if your object floats by dropping it in the pool of water. Now, one thing you may want to note is sometimes our objects just barely float. So for example, if I increase this mass, you can see how it's sort of suspended in the middle of the tank. So to really test to see if it's going to float, sometimes you kind of got to flick it up after it's sunk to the bottom and see if it floats or not. For example, if I take this box, right, that one's going to sink, right? I flick it up, it goes back, right? So this one does not float. Okay. All right. So again, you're going to do that for all of the boxes and do that calculation. Now, in the next table, part B, we're going to look at boxes with the same volume now. So now we're going to hold volume constant, but mass is going to be different. So notice, again, our mass is recorded here. And then our volume we can adjust. Again, if you just leave it alone, it's going to stay at 5.00 liters. So therefore, you can write down the masses for each of these, the volumes for each of these is going to be 5, and then calculate your density. Again, to test if it floats, you're going to drop it into the pool and see, does it float or not? Again, some of them are going to float very obviously, like this one. Again, you have to click and hold it down in order to accurately measure the volume. And then some of them will just barely float. And so you may have to flick it up to really accurately test it, right? And then the third table is we're going to hold the density constant. And again, you can kind of adjust the density to whatever you want. And you'll see, again, the masses are given to you. So you can just write those down. And then, again, test your volume displacement by dropping your blocks into the pool and figuring out what is the difference, all right? For this question right here, it says water has a density of what? You're going to want to look that up on Google, all right? So Google, what is the density of water? And write that down right here. And that's gonna come into play in the next section. All right, so now in part D, we are going to be looking at specific materials and testing their density and whether they float or not. So here you're going to toggle away from the compare tab to the intro tab, and that is going to give you some different things to play around with. So we can change our substance by going up to this little top menu right here and selecting whatever substance it is. So for example, our first substance is styrofoam. We're going to write down the mass, 0.75 kilograms. We're going to, again, test our volume. That's going to be 5.00 liters. Write that down here. Calculate our density, right? So it'd be 0.75 divided by 5 equals. And then does it float or not, right? So we can see, all right, yeah, that one definitely floats, okay? And then we're going to do that for all of the other substances. So to just change your substance, we can now test wood, test ice, so on and so forth. Okay. And then there's a few questions here that I want you to try to answer on your own and see what you come up with. One of the questions is going to ask you Right here, it's going to choose the My Block option in the material drop-down box. So for that, you're just going to go to Custom. And then it's going to say, you know, bring the mass to 4 kilograms. So try to get it close right at 4 if you can. Maybe 4.10 is okay. And then it wants you to figure out what is the minimum volume needed to make the object float. And so what you can do is bring your volume all the way up to the biggest volume you can, and then slowly drop it down and sort of test out, okay, at what volume do we begin to sink, right? And so kind of play around going up and down and then record that volume, okay? And then you're going to answer the following questions. Now, the last part is the mystery section. So here you're going to go again back to the bottom and you're going to click mystery tab. And there's 3 sets of blocks or random. And you can select whatever set of boxes you want to select. So maybe set 3. And you're going to weigh the box, write down the mass. You're going to measure the volume displacement, write that down. You're going to calculate your density. And then you're going to test, does it float or not? And then based on whatever density you get, you're going to come up here to this table of known materials and then try to match your density to the object that has the density closest to it. So for example, if we found that the density was 0.92, then we would say that this substance, block 3A, is most likely ice. Okay. Otherwise, if the density was higher, say the density was like 4.3, then we would look at the table, find the value closest to 4.3, which is titanium at 4.5, and then say it is likely titanium. All right. And so once you're done with that, you're done. So then you can upload your finished document to the Canvas assignment that is under the FET simulation link. Again, reach out to me if you guys have any questions. And this will be due now on Sunday night. So you have a little bit of an extension on that assignment. Okay. I hope you all have a wonderful day. And I will again see you in class Monday. Like, you know, this